How's it, guys? Betting Radio again from NAFTV. Now, it looks like there's a bit of a mix-up here with regards to this game here. Initially, I was told that this was a best of one, or it looked like that on the ESEA side of things. So, as I can see at the moment, it looks like it is actually a best of three. So, apologies here on behalf of the NAFTV site, of course. I'll be going into the game now just to confirm if it is actually a best out of three here, because if you go look at the bracket specifically, there's no indication there on any sort of best out of three. It's just a map that's been given and that's it. So far as I understand, it should actually be a best out of three, I mean, in my opinion here. But now we into the game now, and we can see that the guys have actually joined in into the particular server now. So we're going to take it into the second match here. For some of you guys that might have been misinformed, etc., it looks like it is going to be a best out of three here. So we're just now waiting up for the guys to join in, and we'll be taking this cast onto the second map. So once again, apologies from my side there on not being given the right information. I mean, throughout the entire tournament, it's obviously been the best out of one, but there was no indication whatsoever on the final being a best of three. I did the research myself, but couldn't see anything. And now there's an indication that it is the best out of three by the looks of it. So I'm not too sure, but I need to just get a double confirmation, of course, now from the tournament organizers, just to see what's going on. Right, okay. So, it looks like this is going to be the next championship round here. Dust2 now falling 16-14 to the Flipside team there. We are going to be seeing them playing on Nuke at the moment. It just looks like the format that this has been put together in is actually very misconceived, I guess. Okay, so for the second game here, I'm going to be getting a co-caster. Well, my co-caster will be joining me. It will be Mr. Wookie from CS. How's it, man? Are you there?
Yes, I am.
How are you, good sir? Not too bad. Look, the first map went down to Flipside. Score there was 16-14. If you go look at the ESEA way that it's been put out, right, it seems very confusing there, in my opinion. I mean, it looked to me that it was a best out of one map, right? According to their statistics and everything, it is actually a best out of three, so the game will continue. It's obviously just a general mistake that's been made, I guess, on my side here. But some people also, you know, don't know exactly what's going on or how it's been laid out. But yeah, so we're going to be taking on the second map here, the Inuke between Paranoia and Flipside. Flipside taking the first one. What's your thoughts? I mean, you watched them, you casted with me last night, the Flipside game. So what's your personal opinion on it?
The first map was what exactly?
It was Dust2 and Flipside beat Paranoia there 16-14. The second map, in actual fact, was the first initial map that they played was Nuke, the one that we're seeing here again, and there that was an overtime game, 22-19. If you go look on the statistics on ESEA, you'll see it there yourself. What do you think is gonna be the lineup? Well, the prediction here.
What map are we going to at the moment?
We're on Nuke. I'm going to send you the IP address now of the server.
Are we going on Nuke?
That's
from
correct,
what
yeah.
I saw on Flipside's page, it's going to be interesting because their Nuke is statistically speaking, I think they a bit weak on Nuke.
Yeah.
Their strong map, obviously being Infi, not having lost it yet. Taking the first map, BO3, do you know what the third map is going to be? Because if it's Infi, I don't think this map matters. Terrorists win.
Yeah, well, look, I mean, just looking at the current, the mix-up at the moment, it's been a little bit up and down. People kind of thought it was a best of three, which it is, by the looks of it. It's not actually a best of one. I think the information that got provided to us was incorrect, I guess, because, there are many sources providing information to relevant parties like the CSGO betting lounge, etc.
Uh-huh, Counter-Strike stores.
Yeah, so... I don't know, man. It looks like it was just a basic mistake that was made. But we are in the game now. We are casting the game live here, so we shouldn't have any more problems with it. Obviously, the people that did bet would probably rejoin the cast and so forth. But let's just quickly have a look now at the lineup. So we've got the guys ready here on Nuke. We looked at the past results. The past results were...
mixed.
Yeah, no, well, 19-22 for Paranoia. Are we going to see a similar result here? And if this is a best out of three format, which we can see now, Paranoia should technically take this, well, should have started one up in this final. So now we are currently sitting with a situation where it's one all. So whoever takes this map will be crowned the champions then. And the match starts underway here between these two now, as we can see. And a very interesting startup, do believe.
We're seeing a large presence here on top, as you'd expect. T's waiting lobby, probably I would think they're going to do a drop, or we'll see it now, but they're getting heady there. Oh, another nice heady. Great defense. Yeah. Jumpy with a reply. With a reply, and they're going to take top.
Is your microphone sorted out, by the way? You seem to be very far away. But anyway, just let's quickly get back into the game here. We're looking at the current Paranoia side. Nice play here from Joe Hobie. Well, with a double kill, maybe picking up a third one, which he does. And it's a 1-0 start here to the Paranoia team. And looking pretty fresh and ready to take this map. I think they want to take this map.
Yeah, they obviously coming off a loss on the last map. Sorry about my mic difficulties there. I think they should be fixed now.
Okay. No, cool. You sound a lot better.
Okay. I don't sound like I'm in the bathroom casting from my mic. That's great. we'll see. Teasers traditionally, from 1.6 days, the hard map for them to play. So we'll see how they do. But F3, apparently, as of late, do not mess with them.
Yeah. No, they've got a very strong side, I will admit. The Swedes are definitely... got the right cohesion, synergy factor there for them. But now going into this round, we're seeing the buy round now from the Paranoia team. We're seeing Joby Wild now with the first pick, playing on the outside, managing to pick up a double kill here at the moment. And it is only three left. Jumpy now coming in that tail position from the rampside area. He's getting assaulted there by X7 with the Mac-7 in actual fact. Nice play there from Hydrox. Doesn't get the kill on Joby Wild. Jumpy's going to try and get himself a quick kill here. Doesn't do it. And not a gun lost there for the Paranoia team. Good start here. This is, of course, a heavy CT biased map. But I have seen I have seen this game played kind of in reverse, well, this map, where the terrorist side is actually just scoring most of the rounds. I mean, it's like 9-10 rounds going towards the terrorists and vice versa. So we possibly...
Yeah, but Paranoia doing so much work for his team. Two rounds, he already got six frags. He's averaging three a round.
Which teammate from Paranoia?
Jobiwal,
yeah. Well, we're seeing
why did they make it so
Max 7 work here from X7, managing to get one.
Ooh, the pro Nazi is doing work.
Fantastic play there from X7 and Dexu. And the score now 3-0 now to the Paranoia Esports side.
Yeah, that Pro 90, 50 bullets getting to work there. He made sure he used those 50 bullets, let me tell you. Ooh. Yeah, no, I think unless we see some sneaky drops, or a big buy round win from Tease now, it'll go much the same. It just seems like the Paranoia team is planted. They're just like, come at me, bro.
Yeah. Well, looking at it at the moment, it is a quite an interesting scenario. We're seeing the buy round now in effect here for the Flipside Tactics team. Some movement now coming in towards the outside area. They are struggling a little bit against the CT Onslaught. Jahobi, while playing with the M4, gets himself one pick, and his teammate Dexu gets the grenade kill there. So it's a 4-0 lead now to Paranoia. That little bit of a snowballing effect I see coming in, yeah?
Yeah, as I said, just planted. Like, they're trying to rush into a wall that's full of guns. It's just not working very well. I think that maybe the Flipside team needs to just slow down a little bit and not just jump into the M4s.
Yeah, so now we're seeing another eco round here from the Flipside team going into round 5. And a little bit of a Silocide boost at the moment. Looking to get an opportunity to take some of the members on. Oh, unfortunately, Bossick not getting the pick there. Unfairly doing quite well there. Then Hydrox managing to scrape together a kill. So I hope you are quite effective for the M4A1S.
Canon Relic though. He's picked up the spare. Moving around on this outside area. I don't know if they know where Jahobi Wild is. Probably been called, but... Oof, nice shot by Hydrox. They need a move here. They're going to get caught with their pantaloons around their ankles. Seeing a slow play outside. Be a wait on a pick here, but I think they're gonna run out of time if they don't make a move soon. And it looks like they're gonna go downstairs.
Yeah, no, at the moment, only two of them now. They've got three of the CTs to take on. They've got their guns though, so a good eco round here for Flipside at the moment, but it's looking a little bit pear shaped for them at this moment. If they get the next kill, it's gonna look good.
So they're going to get this man in. Oh, there it is, the man in vents. Yep. Now the plant's going to go down. That's money.
Yep. So Relic getting the kill there, but Dexu coming back, taking out Hydrox in the ventside area. Relic managing to exchange. So it's a one-on-one here between X7 and Relic. And a close game, I do believe this will be.
Oh, great defuse here. Will he get it? No.
Nope.
Relic with the wall bang.
Fantastic shot there through the metal. Getting the also important round here for the Flipside Tactics team. There is still money here for the CT side. As we can see, the T side at the moment, well, you know, they've got cash now they can buy up. So we're going to have a full-on gun battle here between the two. We're seeing the AWP purchase there from Jumpy and the AWP purchase there from Jahobi Wow. And, well, let's see how it goes.
Yeah, big opening time. You know, this round is going to define, I think, the next three or four. Ooh, nice shot by Jahobi Wild through the smoke.
Yeah, clever there. That's definitely put the Paranoia team at an advantage here at the moment. So now we've got only four of the Flipside Tactics members left. And they really need to do the work now to get themselves into a position of possibly walking away with another round win. We're seeing Jahobi Wild on the outside with the AWP, getting a pick there on Barsik. So good start for him with a double kill. And the Flipside side are in a bit of a predicament on the outside area with that red crate. And we're seeing Jahobi Wild now moving more towards the ramp side area at the moment. Just a quick overview look. Jumpy and Relic are still playing the outside. We have Anfeli on the inside as the CT, looking out, just kind of feeding the information through to his teammates. But I think he's not really looking outside.
So yeah, the Paranoia is just so planted. They're not getting shaken by anything. They're not, oh, nice pick outside, but then Jumpy takes him down.
Yeah, Jumpy.
But, just so planted. You know, like, they're not worried. They're like, come to us. We've got the bomb site. We are where you need to be.
Yeah, so looking at it now at the moment, it's really just a case of the Flipside team just needs to eco their guns, as we can see. They really need to kind of go back, re-look at how they're taking things on. Because Jahobi Hiwau is rotating between ramp and outside so effectively, getting the necessary picks, this is it is something that, you know, he is... well, it is benefiting the Paranoia team at the moment. Score now 5-1, and we're seeing Flipside Tactics just a little bit under pressure. But they still buy up. They still got some bucks in the bag. And we're seeing another AWP. Well, we're seeing the saved AWP there from Jumpy going into this particular round. This is going to be a crucial round here for them. Let's just see how it works.
Now, Jumpy doing so much work, as we saw on Infi with that AWP, so he really is a lot of core and hope for his team at the moment. He's got to drop that hammer and drop it hard. Seeing a bomb drop appear, ooh, nice shot by Jumpy, as I say that, in the teeth.
Oh, Relic there with a good reply as well, taking on Joby. Wow, so the AWP out of play here for the Paranoia Esports team. Then we got Hydrox as well, adding
pick.
Nice play here from Flipside, coming back quite strong here. And then we see X7, the first one to get a pick of his team, gets himself a double kill, bomb, drops the bomb. Important, as we can see the Flipside team setting up for the bomb plant below, not being able to do so because the bomb is down. And it is going to be guarded now by the Paranoia side.
Yeah, big play there, just went pear-shaped with that double kill. Really good save there by... like X7, and he gets another one. Now it's all up to Detsku. He's getting caught reloading. Jumpy, just too good on that reload. There's no worse thing to be getting caught doing in Counter-Strike than reloading. I think maybe if you've taken out like a decoy, I think that's the only thing that could possibly be worse than that.
Yeah, well, look, I mean, I'm just reading through the chat here at the moment. It just seems that there's quite a level of confusion at the moment with regards to the ESEA setup. I mean, even we've got we confused completely, seeing that it was a best of one. It looked like a best of one, and everyone basically thought it was. I'm not too sure if CS:GO launch. I think CS:GO Lounge predicted to be a best of three, and looking at this moment, it seems like it is a best of three match here between these two. So there is a level of confusion with regards to some viewers, other viewers, etc., some of the players and so forth. Well, not necessarily the players, but I mean, myself as a caster as well, I got the indication this was a best of one. So looking at it now, it seems like it is a best of three. Going back to the map, the match here. Joby, while getting the first pick here for the Paranoia Esports side, and well, good start here for them, but can Flipside respond with the pick themselves?
Yeah, I think Boss got himself in a nice position here, maybe to take out Joby while, but there's Hydrox taking down Joby while on the rotate. Brilliant play from him, taking out the Danger Man. Yes, yeah. I'm seeing a bit too much static play maybe from the CTs. I suppose X7 is there to watch for the ramp push. And we've got Infeli in the... Here comes the push from underneath heaven. Oh, and they all get taken out. Great shooting there by Infeli to clean up.
Yeah, and Infeli there doing very well. And so looking at it now, it is a very good position that the Paranoia Esports team are in. And Flipside there, of course... you know, winning the first map, they've got a lot of work to do now. They need to get to that 5 or 6 round mark to see if they can, you know, have themselves at least a decent second half, in my opinion.
Yeah, well, what's so nice about Flip Tactics and Flipside, sorry, you know, Tactics and watching them is they're so reactive. They change like every round. Nice try to push outside, but Infeli just locking it down. I do believe Bomb got down. Where is Bomb? Hydrox. Hydrox is actually still on Squeaky.
He's going to be taken out there by Joby well, though. And while the eco round not working too well here for the Flipside team. Relic is downstairs, though, but it would have been like very good for them if they just could have got the bomb plant, in my opinion.
Yeah.
But, well, It looks like Flipside at the moment, you know, have got a lot of work on their hands as the Paranoia Esports side should rack it up to 7 rounds now. 7-2.
Yeah, and as you say, just a little bit of that steamroll. You know, they came back with 2 rounds and then they need a reply soon, before 10. If they get to 10-2, I don't see... If they do a good bye round, yes, they've got a chance. But they need a reply soon. They really do.
Yeah, I'm sure that a lot of people are hoping for Flipside here to reply. We're seeing the buy run come into effect now. 3 Gunnels and 2 AK-47s. So this could actually work for them, I do believe. We'll have to wait and see in the next couple of moments now. We're seeing a bit of aggressive play here from Anfeli. Doesn't seem to be bothered too much. Some outside play now here from the Flipside team. They obviously... taking that bomb outside lowers and hopefully, well no, looks like they're coming outside. And Feli setting himself up here for a good couple of sprays. Then we're seeing the tail from the squeaky side area, and a lot of exchanges here has favored the Paranoia team. And there we go.
Too much left for Hydrox, you know, low HP. Rush didn't really work. The defense is so solid.
Yeah, well, look, I mean, I think what was a big factor there was the fact that Anfeli basically moved into the door side, squeaky side door area, and he stayed there. And because he came out a little bit later, he basically set himself up for a quick kill. Most of the Flipside team looked at him, and the guys from Heaven just took him out straight away. And now looking at it now, it's another eco round here for the Flipside team. Just looking, it just seems very difficult at the moment now for them. Being able to get some traction, although we might see a completely different result in the second half.
Big tags by Anfeli though.
Anfeli managing to get himself a kill there finally. And then very well played there from the rest of the Paranoia side as they isolate off the Flipside Tactics team now. Score now 9-2.
And I think they actually would have succeeded on that outside push if they had thrown a smoke there. But, you know, maybe these guys don't like lung cancer. I don't know what their story is.
Yeah. Well, let's just have a quick look now and see how the following will work here for the Flipside team. I mean, they've got a full buy of AKs, so they should be able to get some form of a... some form of traction at the moment now, moving into the bottom side area. We're seeing that bomb moving quite closely, although Paranoia is waiting for them and fairly spamming through the smoke there. Nothing really coming from it at the moment.
That howl looks so awesome. I don't know how wise this is from Flipside to be pushing, but they've got the guys outside.
Now we're seeing some left side push here from Flipside as well. Unfortunately, Hydrox going down there, and so does Zape. So good play there from Joby Wow and X7. And at the moment, we're seeing it's a 5-on-3 situation here. The T side have to desperately get this bomb down if they want to actually keep themselves in this game at the moment. Seeing some spam shots here, and Finny doing very well. Gets himself a third kill, and that's it. A 10-2, fantastic play here from Paranoia. Just really rocking the momentum.
Yeah, and you can see now the economy telling the tale of the tape. You know, 10-2, forcing a bar now at this point. You know, if they don't take this round, it's going to be 13-2 at the end of this. The guys are just putting it down out there. Joby Wow doing so much work for his team. Over 5 KD. Absolutely amazing play from him. And the other guys not slacking, you know. I mean, even their worst players coming up on being the second best on the other team.
Yeah. Well, let's just see another buy round in effect here for... I think that's losing round bonus here that the Flipside team are... Well, they've got, but they need to make this count now. This is the also important round here for them. If Paranoia gets 11 rounds, it's really much so difficult for the Flipside team as CTs to keep this game in order.
Yeah, make them break time.
We see Billy playing around the corner, getting the pick on Relic here. And Bossic being taken on from all angles, and so we're seeing just aggressive play here from the Paranoia side on the retake, and it is a 11-2 lead here for Paranoia Esports. Very well played here from the Finnish team.
What are in Jahobi's Wild's bullets, dude? Is he shooting like depleted uranium? I want to know. I want to get those bullets for my gun. They apparently work better than other bullets.
Well,
because my word.
If you look at his KPD at the moment, I mean, it's really, really high. He's sitting on 17 for 3. But the rest of the team is also following suit there. The only player that seems to be struggling a little bit on this map is Aheen with 6 for 5. But he's still on a positive KPD there at the moment. So, looking at this current setup here, we're seeing that flip side again with the buy round, but just Galil's more so. Trying to see if they can get themselves a quick pick or two. They need to try and work something out here. They need to get themselves at least 4 rounds here, in my opinion. This is a very crucial part in this particular game where they need to hold on.
Yeah, because if you lose pistol round going on the other side, you're really up the creek. And the paddle is not only gone, it's been set on fire. But Jumpy here, nice pick onto ramp. That's them going down. We're probably going to see a vent drop. There it is. But Jumpy ready for it. Nice heady on Infeli. To two down, they're taking side. Toby Wild being a ninja on the left-hand side. Out of nowhere.
Are we seeing
Bossic? But him getting
as
taken
well.
Down and a heen.
So Dex with the last one left here. He's going to try and get himself quick clicks, but doesn't get the bomber. Ooh, he's getting spammed like crazy now through this back end. He manages to get Jumpy down. But he's still got 3 terrorists to take on. Relic waiting for this. And that's
six
it.
HP.
There we go. The Flipside Tactics team managing to secure themselves another round. This could still end up being a very close game, in my opinion.
Yeah, they have to get this fourth. It's really... Come, boys. Let's do it. I'm just looking at the scores. I'm feeling very sorry for Zape. He must feel like the coolest kid with Down syndrome at this point. Coming in at 0-1 and 14 deaths.
Yeah. Now Zape just really struggling at the moment for his team, trying to get some traction here and getting himself at least a kill or two. Looking at it at the moment now, Paranoia strikes with the first kill and then X7 with another. Seeing some spam play here. Hydrox doing quite well for his team, managing to get one. But it is a 3-on-4 situation. The CTs have got the numbers here. And the terrorists...
And they've got the vents.
That's also... Yeah, no, that's also quite true. Vents... If you've got control of the vents in the outside area, it is also in your favor as a team. Regardless of what team type you are. But we're seeing that the Flipside team now moving towards the left-hand side here. What will the Paranoia members do? The defender there is doing quite low on the HP. Oh, a pick there on Joby. Wow. And then a quick pick there on X7 after taking one down. So it's a 2-on-2 situation. And this could still be... Wow. It's very difficult right now for the Flipside team.
Yeah, both of them very low. No, sorry. It's only Hydrox left. He's going to have to pull some stuff off here to make this happen. Very smart play with the running on the rail.
Gets himself
a nice pick on Dixu. Tom.
Doesn't get
the
bomb.
That is so unfortunate.
Oh, that's very unfortunate there. But now the half kicking off here between these two. And the score now 12-3. Sure, eh? Pistol round underway here. No? Or are they still AFK? I think they might just do the quick restart, yeah.
Yeah, there's people with AKs. I'm like, what? Just around? What's going on?
Well, look, I mean, looking at Paranoia at the moment, they are 12-3 ahead here. But I do firmly believe Flipside takes this round. They can take it all the way. Because CT sides or CT stronger CT-based sides could actually produce that sort of result, in my opinion. But
yeah, and as you say, it's exactly what we saw yesterday when we were casting them on Infi. You know, they had a bit of a struggle in the beginning. But as soon as they've got CT side, they just absolutely steamrolled to the finish.
Yeah, it really... really is a case of how well are they going to be able to settle in as the CT side, you know, and then go for and then go for the picks there. I mean, you know, once they've got the guns in hand here and the cohesion's right, it can be all the way straight through to the end here for the Philip side, for the Swedish team. But let's get into this first pistol round here between these two. We're seeing a little bit of play on the left-hand side here from Paranoia. Zape already feeding the information through. That might be a little bit of a decoy as the rest of the team are setting up to go for a topside position push here. Hydrox is ready. But Paranoia just breaching in aggressively. They seem to have redone their strat thinking here, because this map just seems awfully, awfully one-sided at the moment for the Paranoia team.
Yeah, I just feel like F3 hesitated a little bit there. They saw it coming and they just sort of were like, should we go, you know, like that indecisiveness, I think, just cost them that pistol round, and that's a big round to lose, you know, for them. I think for this map, that might be the nail in the coffin.
Yeah, well, look, I don't think it's over yet. I mean, this is the second round here. The score is 13-3 now to the Paranoia Esports side. And looking at it at this moment in time, they are pretty much favorites to go through and win the championship round after the very confusing information that's provided on the ESEA website, unfortunately. A lot of people thought this was a best of one, and some thought it was a best of three. But looking at it now, coming through the roof, Dexter getting first pick there on Relic, and the Flipside team obviously trying to gather up their members where they can so they can defend off this T-side onslaught at the moment. Now look at this, Paranoia taking quite, like, they're taking their time at the moment. We might see a pick here, yes we do. Zape does get the pick, but gets taken out there by Dexter with the Pro 90. Bosic, oh, playing quite well here on the outside with the USP. So we should see a top launch here with the smoke off now. It's a 3-on-3, three pistols versus three guns. Or bigger size guns. We're seeing one SMG and two rifles.
Very nice smoke play by the Paranoia guys. Buying themselves some time on a planted bomb. Very nice play. We see Jumpy with a picked up gun here. Coming in mouth. Oh, he misses the pick.
Nice play here from Hydrox as well, getting the pick, and look at Barsic as well. So now it's a 2-on-1. They need to make quick if they want to get the bomb defuse. Not going to happen. It is going to be another round here for the Paranoia side, but a very, very good eco round there nonetheless.
Yeah, downing four guns, getting one for your team, you know. Good money in for them, you know. They can maybe force a buy here and bring it back, but it's really... This is the wire.
Yeah, this is pretty much the wire for Flipside. So for some of you guys that have just watched, have just joined in or currently watching the stream, the current standings is 1-1 with regards to map scores. The Paranoia side went 1-0 up in the grand final championship round because they haven't lost a singular game in the entire bracket. And Flipside taking the first match this evening, 16-14 on Dust 2. But looking at it right now, Paranoia are in such a position here to take this final. Although Flipside are trying their best. Oh, shot there from Barsic with...
You've got your Obi-Wan in the vents though, this could be dangerous.
Now we've got Hydrox though, that might actually catch him off guard. We're seeing some mouth action here as well. Relic as well. Goes in, gets himself a quick pick there on Naheen. Ooh, gets taken out there by X7. But Barsic is waiting. Gets the pick. So this is a good round here for the CTs at the moment.
Could this be a comeback?
It could
comeback
be.
Comeback kit. And oh, well. And there's Joby Wild down.
There we go. So, 14-4,
as I said, hey guys. It's do or die. They're just like, oh really? Okay, we'll be Swedish, yeah? Amazing bit of play from them. Going full Thor. No, not holding back at all. Exciting CS. This is actually nail-biting stuff. If it wasn't so cold, I would have bit through them already.
Well, look, I mean, Flipside have got a lot of work to do. It is an eco round now for the Paranoia team. Let's see if Flipside can keep their composure and their synergy together to take it all the way through. But we're seeing their X7 doing very well. Relic, though. Some support here from Hydrox. Gets himself a double kill. Hydrox with a trip kill. And the last one left is Dexu. Dexu managing to take down Barsic here at the moment. And it's still a 3-on-1 situation. A very good eco round here for the Paranoia team. They've managed to take two guns and collect one of them. We'll just have to see what Dexu does. It looks like he's going to go straight for the eco here, the save.
He might just get tangled up with Hydrox if he's not too careful. But, yeah, very well played from F3. Just to turn around under so much pressure and then just go, you know, two rounds. But, ooh, it looks like, as I say, Dexu might be walking himself into a bit of trouble here.
Running it out. Ooh, gets taken out there by Hydrox. So he doesn't save the gun, which is quite interesting. But, well, they are pretty much 9 runs ahead now. Score now 14-5. And the Swedish team, well, another eco round.
And we're seeing all bars. Am I seeing an all bar? Did I see an all bar?
Yeah, no, you didn't. Jumpy's got the AWP again.
There's an all bar. So now we've got an AWP on CT, which does not bode well for T. There's no more outside for you. You are just going to eat Thor's hammer.
Well, let's have a quick look at... Jumpy on the outside here. See if he can get the pick. Yep, there we go. First pick here for Jumpy at the moment. He's doing... He's got the right... Oh, look at him. Just picking them off like grapes from a tree. And Barsic as well, adding to the tally at the moment. So does Relic. A very easy round by the looks of it here for the Swedish team.
Poor Jehobi was like, hey guys, guys, damn. Yeah, and Jehobi, well, not in the best of places to be. And Barsic cleaning up.
Very good. Nice round there for the Swedish team. We should see the buy round now in effect for Paranoia. Paranoia only 2 rounds away from taking this. But we could see the Swedes stealing this from them. Although, this is the important round, I do believe, for the Paranoia team. They really need to take this round just to secure the win. But I don't think it's going to be easy for them, man.
No, this is a very, very hard climb. They basically can't lose a round. No. I mean, if anything goes that pear-shaped, they're done.
Look, some of the users saying there it might be a 16-16. Yeah, if only. But, well, you never know, eh? Flipside Tactics might just bring this one all the way back down to the wire. We're seeing some interesting setups here from the Paranoia team at the moment in the side, the lobby side area. And it is slow play. So we're now just awaiting for the next strat to be called. I think they're running on a timer here, probably about 35 to between 35 and 55 seconds. They probably will be executing some form of a push.
Waiting that pick though.
Or it could be pick based. Interesting, yeah. Well, nice Molotov there from the CT side. Just halting that the push. Oh, dangerous there. Jumpy and Zay both getting picks. Jehobi well managing to get one. But look at Relic now. Coming from the staircase area, taking out X7 and putting the Paranoia team in such, well, a bad disadvantage at the moment. And there we go. The picks have been made. So now, 7 rounds away, the Flipside team can still take it.
Yeah, their eco is looking very nice. They only lost one gun that round. You know, Zay is starting to come to the party as well, which is great for them. Very, very turnaround player. Exactly what we saw yesterday on Infi. They might not play the T side very well, but my word, their composure on CT, they also just like a wall of death and mayhem, and they're just actually showing off a little bit right now.
Well, I wouldn't say. I think now it's pretty much they are desperate to try and keep within reach here. We're seeing the isolation here from the Flipside team playing absolutely very well, going for the quick incendiary grenade on the door side. Nice pick from Jehobi well though, but it's still pressure. X7, the last one there. He's got to clutch, but doesn't, and gets taken out there by Zape. And 14-8, Flipside are coming back, eh? Slowly but surely.
Yeah, and they don't even care about those gun drops. The guy's $13,000. He's like, oh, I got guns. Oh, yeah. And we're seeing a new cannon come out on Relic. That could be devastating.
What?
I think that is the most underrated weapon in the game. It is so strong.
No, the auto sniper, definitely. Very good gun, in actual fact. The old terminology of some people calling it the noob cannon, I think, is not really existent anymore. It's the auto sniper now for a reason, because it's a very effective gun. But now we're seeing another buy round here from the Paranoia team at the moment. Quite interesting. Quickly looking at the scores here. Jahobi, well, right on top there, 24-11. And then we're seeing slowly but surely Zape bringing his side here, 5-20 for his team. He's got a lot of work to do to try and get it up to at least a 1 KPD. But now at
the
moment,
I think that's out of his reach, though. I think if he could bring up to half KPD.
Okay, possibly, but just looking at the setup now, it's a very much stagnated lobby setup again here from Paranoia. Maybe just it's a sign of they're trying to go for a specific strat. We're seeing,
but they're just getting red by Flipside, and Flipside just absolutely putting it down now. Completely different to what we saw earlier.
Very, very interesting situation here at the moment. Oh, we're seeing Jumpy taking the last shot there.
In the face!
49. Yep, it's getting close. It's getting closer. We might see a double figure here. We will see an eco round by the looks of it from the Paranoid Esports team. And look at this. Look at Flipside. They are coming back strong. They are showing their power. Well, not their power, I would say. Their skill with regards to setting up correctly as a CT-based side. And making it very difficult for the Paranoid Esports team here.
Yeah, and that composure, as I said before, just, hey guys, we got 3 rounds. But now, look at it, it's a different story. Oh, and a good push here, but just getting owned by that auto sniper, putting it down, as I said, really underrated. Nice little pick there by Hin, but then cleaned up by Relic and Barsic.
So now we're looking at it now, 10-14, the Flipside Tactics team are in double figures. Things could change here for them, but let's see if Paranoia can actually take this round. They've got an AWP purchase there. Jahobi WoW obviously will be challenging the outside area or perhaps left side ramp. He might challenge that auto sniper, but I don't know. Looking at it now at the moment, the flip side are just looking very solid. They are taking round for round from this Finnish team, making it very, very difficult.
Yeah, and the harassment there, I mean, just with nades, they've already taken 45 HP off one of the players, another 30 off unfairly, and they haven't had to fire around yet. They're just sitting on their standard setup, and they are getting damage done. And they just, it's very sneaky, very, very awesome. None of them seem to be in positions that are going to affect them adversely to being, you know, in a lot of bad predicaments and bad spaces.
Yeah.
Just fantastic play from Flipside.
Yeah, well, looking at it now, Jumpy with the one kill. Relic also now adding to the tally. Jumpy with a second. And then we see Zape coming in from the bottom, taking out the bomber. And all of a sudden, X7 is the last one left here for the Paranoia team. And at the moment, he's just in a very tricky predicament. He needs to try and get kills, and gets taken out there by Zape. Score now 14-11. Look at this. This is close now. Now all of a sudden, 3-round difference between these two. What fantastic play here from Flipside. I mean,
yeah, and
really,
Zape just folding him in half there. I don't know if you saw that in the midair. He took the head and his model like folded in half. It's like quite funny.
Yeah, no, I've seen some very interesting things with regards to like models in CS:GO, where it just doesn't look right, you know. Like they position themselves in such funny angles. It just really doesn't look right. But anyway, back to the game now. So we're seeing now a full AK buy here from Paranoia, and I think that is with regards to a little bit of losing bonus there from a monetary point of view. So looking at the current scores here, 21-9, Relic on top there.
Ooh, quick pick there. Passing through the smoke.
Amazing shot there, and he kind of was half flashed as well. So he starts off the round with a good kill, And Paranoia now, only 4 members to take on the 5 of the CTs. Can they equalize it out? Looks like Zape taking on that ramp position, automatically moving right down. Johobi Wow now just making his way through now to the topside area. Hydrox is going to be busy. He gets taken out. Relic doing quite well with one. Bossick also getting himself a trip kill and, sorry, a quad kill in actual fact. Fantastic topside play there from Bossick, shutting down the Paranoia onslaught. And score now 14-12. Look at this. Look how close we are getting.
The roof is on fire. We just need a Bossick and the Paranoia burns. Burn, Paranoia, burn.
Well,
yeah, that's basically what's happening. I mean, I just, this is so exciting now. I must say, I'm really on the edge of my seat here going, what is going to happen, you know? Absolutely amazing play from the flip side.
Yeah, we're seeing the eco round now in effect here for the Paranoia team. And they're obviously just trying to wait for any aggressive play here from Flipside at the moment. But Flipside just kind of taking their time. They know they've got the rounds in the bag. They know they've got the stronger team. We see the left side play now. Zape taking one. Does he get himself another? Yes, he does. Fantastic play. Oh, one fantastic ace. Oh, my word. Did you see that?
Yeah, he came late to the party, but he came to the party. And he came there with, what was that? That pistol, those pistol headies. He was just flicking to them like, oh my word, the man has played too much dot to dot, let me tell you, at speed, to do that.
Well, that is fantastic to watch that sort of skill. And we see Zape now, hey, well look, he might just get that one KPD now, 13 for 21, not bad play here from Zape with that fantastic ace.
My words.
And the score now 13-14, Flipside are literally one round away from drawing it up. And 3 rounds away from winning this.
That composure though. I've been on the wrong end of this. It's not easy.
Oh, that was an amazing ace to see. I mean, that was amazing. We're seeing the AWP shot now from Jumpy on the outside, taking down Johobi Wow, and that's the AWP out of play here for the Paranoia team. Things are looking tough for them at the moment. And, well, they need to try and make their move towards the left-hand side here. We've got Zape again in action. Let's see what he can do. Ooh, Relic needs to be careful, but he's, well, takes out the bomber. Ahin there shooting, unfortunately, not aware of the player on the stairside area. Jumpy and Zape now trying to control. Ooh, Jumpy here with the AWP, getting himself hits where, ooh, gets taken out there by Unfelly. And Unfelly, the last player left here for Paranoia. And it looks like Flipside are going to draw this up. And a very dangerous position the Paranoia team are putting themselves into. So just quickly looking at the finances at the moment, they are not exactly in the best place to buy up. We're seeing that one of their players there, Johobi Wow, $150, he will have to obviously eco the next round, which is the also important round here for the Flipside Tactics team. So,
but there we go. And Feli gonna probably save that AWP for that eco, unless he gets picked by one of the guys outside.
Yeah, it's a better thing to do because the rest of his team can obviously buy. Let's just quickly look at the finances. Yeah, they can buy up AKs, etc. So not too much of a problem, but the score now 14 apiece. This is the crucial round here for Paranoia if they want to take this final. Now Flipside needs to dig in hard and go for some great defense if they want to, you know, also go for that final shot. Because at the moment it is one apiece between these two. And according to, well, I have to confirm in actual fact that it is one apiece here, but this might just be a completely different setup. So, looking at the moment, as we can see, it's drawn up 14 apiece here. So, bomb has been dropped down there, but no one has been taken out now. We're seeing Relic playing with the auto sniper rifle on the B.
Got a lot of traction outside though. That could be dangerous for the Flipside team. I don't know if they're aware of how many people are actually down there.
No, I don't think they are aware of how many people are actually down there. That actually might just catch them off guard, but I'm sure the information is being sent now to the team as the rest of the Paranoia team are moving in towards the downside area. They haven't played here much. And this could actually work for them if they can get that bomb down effectively. A lot of their strats have been kind of topside pushes, bot side push, topside rushes, and then left side rushes. Let's see if this one actually works now for Paranoia.
Yeah, they've actually got themselves into a very good position here at Blood Lowers. It doesn't look like anybody's really there except for Bossick. Maybe you can pull a Zapier and get a nice.
Now we're seeing the bomb now going down for the team. We're seeing now Hydrox drop. Good play here from Dexu, taking out Barsic with one. The auto sniper in effect here. Ooh, looking tough here. Joby, wow, just really crashing through the Flipside team. And
what a comeback.
This all of a sudden has changed things around here. As we see Aheen getting the score up, and it's a 15-14. Are we going to see another overtime here? Because it does really look like that, in my opinion.
Yeah, I know. It's sort of do or die for Flipside. I think that, you know, letting so many get through outside unawares was a bit of an oversight by them, especially on a round as important as that was. But if they play the game that they played previously, I think, in the last 11 rounds that they took in a row, I think we're going to be okay.
Yeah.
And see some overtime.
So now, the full buy from both teams. Everyone has got AKs, everyone's got AWPs, everyone's got armor and grenades. Let's see what happens in the next few moments here. We're seeing some outside play here from the Flipside team, from the Paranoia team. That strat obviously worked for them, but now Relic, I think, is in a different position. Yeah, he's waiting in that vent side area. He's obviously going to block them off. Knowing that there is a possibility, Paranoia might come lowers again because of that previous strat that worked. But now Paranoia playing the outside, but Jehobi Wild now coming in lowers with the AWP. He's going to go for the nade shot.
Looks like they're kind of walking into the trap, though.
We're seeing the rotation still not occurring here for at the moment, but Dexu doing very well with the one kill. Boss coming in from behind, he gets one, and so does Jumpy. Boss doing very well there with a double kill. He can make this work for his Flipside team. Nice play there from Anfeli, taking out one. Oh, Jumpy with the other, and that's it. We've got a tie, guys. This is quite nail-biting.
What is going on? It's so hectic. This is, oh my word. Oh, and my CS just couldn't even deal with the excitement and decided to have a little crash.
Yeah, it tends to do this on a round change from time to time. I'm luckily still in, so we are still seeing the guys here. And we're obviously going to be waiting now for the overtime to take place, as far as I'm aware. Just have to wait and see. So I'm just trying to get clarification with regards to the setup of this match here, because I'm going to be honest here, the website is not very clear with regards to the match format or the format on this particular bracket. So this has obviously caused a hell of a lot of confusion between a couple of people. Well, a lot of people, in actual fact. So we're just trying to see how this actually does work. So I'm just going through. See, there's no indication whatsoever with regards to the playoff map here. I'm going through the rules, of course. So we're obviously now just waiting for the start of the overtime here between these two teams. The overtime should consist of 6 rounds, 3 rounds per half. Single map playoff if all other tiebreaker scenarios are indecisive. That's basically, there's a double elimination bracket for the intermediate division. You see that the rules are also very strange.
They were probably made while sharing a keg. These things happen.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get clarification with regards to this. I do know that there is an overtime involved, of course. But we just need to get clarification now. This should be now a best out of three, as far as I'm aware. Now waiting for the Flipside team, of course, to ready themselves up, and then the overtime should start. So here we go. Freestyle 15 seconds. Overtime maximum rounds is 3. Overtime starting money is 10,000. So that's the usual overtime. Well, the normal overtime settings or config, but. Obviously, Flipside just maybe having a little bit of a team chat now, a little pep talk before going into this overtime.
Do they switch each round, by the way, or do they just play as they are? Because if that's the case, I think Flipside has a huge advantage being on CT here.
Look, I think it's a case of either or, because at the half you swap teams, you swap then back to the Terrorist or back to the CTs, but. Of course, it is dependent on which side starts first. I mean, you would probably rotate back to the start. Well, you probably finish off with the side that you started off first with. But the rules differ, of course.
It's a problem with nerds. Everybody has to, like, create their own thing, you know?
Yeah. I think it's just the standard overtime rules. As I can see, of course, it is indicated so on the rules page. But I'm just trying to like find out with regards to. The match process with this championship round. As far as it was indicated on the site, it indicated their best of one. Well, not indicated, but you could see it was only a best of one. At the moment. Difficult to see it. So Flipside still AFK at the moment.
Yeah, it very much seems so.
Look, I'm going to give them a lot of credit coming back from a. What was the score there on the end?
12-3 first round.
12-3 at the first round. And then it was a 14-3. And that's when they started bringing it back. Like, literally, Paranoia was a round or two away from actually taking this match. And fantastic play from Flipside. Just really showing a lot of composure, cohesion, etc. And just really, really working the magic.
Banging out 11 rounds in a row is no mean feat. I mean, no matter what you say, CT map, bars, whatever, economy, it doesn't matter what you say. 11 straight round wins. You are inside your opponent's head. You know that you've got him, and you just keep pressing that advantage. And they did it with such immaculate style. I mean, that ace from Zape, yeah. So unexpected.
Crazy. Just,
bam! What is up? How's it going? How's your father? You know.
Yeah, no, that was pretty crazy. I mean, it was a fantastic ace. Like, he used his weapons so well. Like, got the first three picks with the M4, switched to the pistol, got the one, and then just did this amazing little flick shot on the second. And it was really, really good. Okay, it looks like they are restarting now for the overtime. So we are ready to go. I'm sure everything is 100% set and ready from our side. Your takes. This is going to be interesting. We can see Flipside starting off as the CT, and then Paranoia will continue as the Terror side. What do you think?
Ninjutsu. It's going to come down to what they did in that round where they pulled it back. You know, getting a sneaky movement in some way. I'm very surprised I haven't seen a drop yet. There has been no attempt at a vent drop, which, yeah. You know, I understand the defensive play on Flipside has been great, but... Yeah, I think that's even a delayed vent drop, I think it could pay dividends for them now.
Yeah. Well, we're seeing that the Paranoia team playing the outside again, so they're obviously going to work on going lowers. But, well, look at Relic playing the top side in this case. Nice plays here from Jumpy. Gets himself one, gets himself another. Oom doesn't get the last one. Johobi, well, managing to pick him off there. So it's a 2-on-4 situation. He's done the damage, Jumpy, and he's, well, his teammate Relic here. So, well, Johobi, well, the last one left, and flip side in a good position.
Yeah, I know. That's a great opener. Boom, headshot. There we go. You know, that cross, I think they were waiting for it. It's become a bit predictable now. That's why I said maybe they, if they had mixed it up and gone for something they hadn't done in the last, you know, 30 rounds that they played, or 15 rounds on T that they played, that might have paid dividends for them. But, yeah, just getting caught, going to the same place. The flip side guys going, are you serious? You coming at us here again? Well, this is what you get. And they're really paying the price for it there.
Yeah, well, things are looking pretty good at the moment for the Flipside team. There's still a buy run in effect here. Oh, look at Jumpy through the smoke getting X7 there. Gets himself another one. Does he get himself a third? Not really. But he's done the damage on the outside here. Fantastic play. He's got two for the price of nothing. Oh, doesn't get the pick there. He's going to try and go for it again. Nope. Looks like there might be some action actually here on the ramp side. Oh, look at this. Joby Wow with one kill on Jumpy. And now, and Feli taking down Zape on the ramp side position. Now, there's a bit of a problem here for the CTs. They don't have the numbers. And we've got the T side that obviously are in a slight better position. They've got the ability to walk around. But we're seeing Relic take out Dexu there. And Hydrox taking out and Feli putting the CTs back in play.
No one at Heaven, which could be a bit of a problem here. But Joby Wild opting to go for the ramp side. Pushing in quite loudly, I'm surprised by his rapid movement, but yeah, Bosek waiting for him. Knew exactly where he was coming.
Do you think this is going to be a 22-19 win for Paranoia by chance? Because that was the last result on this particular map between these two teams. It was so close. And look, we're back here again. Amazing comeback here from Flipside. They are going to hopefully take this round 3-0 up. But, you know, I'm not trying to show any bias here at the moment. But the Swedes are playing fantastic CS. And as we can see, they just seem to be really much in the right mindset to take this final.
Flipside trying a rush here, or Paranoia at least, sorry, on the ramp. Getting through, but Hydrox with a nice pick there. But we see the guys, so ready for them. 1-2. And that's really put the brakes on them. Joby well behind him, though.
A very interesting one there. Zape's still doing very well. You're managing to pick up 3. And then we're seeing Barsic also trying to get himself another pick there, but he's gone into the toxic room. And there we go. The defuse in effect here, so it should be a 3 out of 3 half year for the Flipside team. And that's when the swap will take place between these two. So, interesting one this. So, over time, 1 at the moment. It's 3-0. For the Flipside Tactics team. Of course, if one of these members, well, one of the, if the Flipside Tactics team wins a round here, they win the match. And we'll have to be, it's going to be very interesting to see exactly how Paranoia are going to handle this. I mean, it's been a hell of a long amount of rounds that they've been losing one after the other. Are they going to have enough confidence going into this particular half to keep the Flipside momentum at bay?
Yeah, this is a very, very tough mental game that they're playing here. You know, Zape coming from a 0-14 to 17-24. You know, their whole team sort of just came alive when they went CT. And geez, they've paid a lot of price for it. I think their challenge right now is just to keep their cool, hold their spots, and it'll probably pay dividends. Oh, but what a nice Mount Rush move, yeah. Oh, getting caught by Infeli though. 2 picks to 2. Nice nade by Dexu. Hey you, catch!
Yeah, interesting predicament now. It's a 2-on-3 situation here. The smoke in effect. And Hydrox has got some work to do with his teammate Jumpy in order for them to possibly get this round. It could possibly happen. We're seeing them smoking and isolating the sites off very, very prettily. Very pretty, more so. Nice pick there from Relic, from Jumpy on Dexu. Goes in, gets himself another one. It's just 1-on-1 here at the moment. This could be it for Paranoia. Oh, oh. And X7 keeps it in the game.
I'm sure these two teams are sick of each other now on this map. Both of them are like, come on! What is going on? This is so frustrating!
Yeah, no, well, looking at it at the moment now, good start here for Paranoia, managing to walk away with the round there. They lost a little too many guns, in my opinion, but it is the first round of the second half, so they still got cash in the bag to go and buy up. Now, this is the important one. If Flipside manage to take enough guns from them, they're going to have a problem in the third round, I believe. Even though with the round win, if Flipside, of course, if they plant the bomb as well. But it's really difficult to say in these overtime position or predicaments. Oh, we're seeing, there we go, and Feli with the first kill on Jumpy. So there needs to be an exchange of some sort. We're seeing some downside play here. Hydrox doing well, managing to take down one, but then Infeli with a double. So still not favorable at the moment for the Flipside team. Zape very low in the HP. Jahobi well in a good position as well on the staircase.
Ah, boss is getting taken now. And there's Zape through the smoke. I don't know how he divined that he was there, but anyway, that's an amazing bit of play from them now. Only one gun lost, still very big economy on X7 for this round, so no problems there on guns. Obviously, a force buy for Flipside, not that it matters, because this is the round that they need here to get the win, but such amazing play. Really, as you say, nail-biting stuff. Just coming down to the wire. I don't understand how games are this close, you know, at this sort of stage of the competition.
Yeah, for sure. And it's, but you know, this is the stage of the competition. This is the type of games you will expect. And at the moment, Paranoia are one round away from taking this. And we're just looking now at the Flipside team. Ooh, Joby Wild being taken out there by Jumpy. So Flipside still have money in the bank here. Luckily. Jumpy going for the AWP purchase now, so they're already, the CTs are one man down, so they're a little stretched thin in this particular instance. They need to really consider how they're going to cover their sights and cover their angles. And we're seeing Hydrox as well, just waiting for any aggressive play from the ramp player, but X7 is really much kind of just sitting it in. He's not really pushing or retreating, more so. We're seeing Barsic coming around the corner here, under the heaven side. And now Hydrox and his team is following suit, now going down. Barsic being taken out there by Dexu. Nice positioning here at the moment.
Oh, nice shot by Zape.
That's a critical shot here. Oh, look at Hydrox, and that's it. Flipside Tactics take it. What a fantastic last round there. Sure, I mean, that was just all of a sudden. They get the kills left, right, and center. And wow, what play. I mean, I'm going to have to get confirmations quickly from the tournament heads with regards to if they actually won that game. But it was really...
I don't want to hop on about it, but it's exactly what we saw yesterday. The guys, maybe their T side needs a bit of work, you know, just to make it complete, I would say, in their gameplay and make it more rounded. But their CT side play is just so ridiculous. If they get going, there is nothing to stop them. They just run away with it. They're just like, no, go all, we are the Sound of Music, these are the hills, and we own them, and no, we're actually using machine guns, and you will die.
Yeah.
They just, out of nowhere, just come with amazing, amazing play, such great composure, as you say, cohesion, teamwork, off the charts.
Yeah.
And I really feel a lot like they're having fun, though, and I think that might be... I don't know, I can't hear their chatter, I don't know what they're doing, but I'm watching how they're playing, and it seems like everything is about the team, you know, reject the self and play for each other type of thing, and I think maybe that's what's brought them into being what they are now.
Yeah, for sure. Well, you know, it is quite interesting to see at the moment how this Flipside team just really came back so strong. I mean, you know, they obviously won the first map 16-14, but really, I mean, fantastic comeback there. I mean, what, they were 14-3 down in the second half, pistol round lost, second round lost, and then all of a sudden they just started building it again, hopping onto that whole train of momentum and working the way all the way through to the overtime, and then taking the overtime and the end there. I mean, it's phenomenal play. So it looks
and just to interrupt you there, sorry man, that ace there, you know, on the ramp rush, really must have just been like, that's hitting YouTube soon in his highlight reel, because my word, you do not see that every day.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that was pretty amazing stuff, in my opinion. I didn't expect, you know, that sort of caliber of an ace to actually, like, develop from someone like Zape that was sitting on naught for 20 in the half. I mean, crazy stuff.
He got proper, like, teeth kicked in, I'm going to roll him and die now, thanks, bro. But just all of a sardine, like, oh, ace, sit up, man. Making up for lost time.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's it looks like the betting unfortunately the betting didn't work out so well, because of the information that was fed through from the ECA, or I'm not sure exactly who, but a lot of people had different ideas or different a different perspective with regards to was this a best out of one? Was this a best out of three? You know, we initially thought it was a best out of one, and only to find out that there was another match played in actual fact, and Flipside, you know, took both. So the result on the end of the day is kind of the same in actual fact. Flipside beating the Paranoia team at the moment. I'm not too sure if there is another match waiting, which I doubt. But so otherwise, I mean, Thursday night we got the Do Gaming League. That's going to be a very good game to watch. Eternal Conflict versus Immersion. I think those two teams are going to really have it at each other. Or what do you think about those two teams in particular?
You know, I'm very excited for that match, because I think it's like the fight of the underdogs. I think we're going to see very close between the two teams. I think they're quite well matched. I'd have to... You know, my heartstrings are being pulled for IAM. I feel like they did so well against BBD on Dust 2, and they were so unlucky to come out of that, you know, 16-14 down. I feel like they need a W, you know, and for going that, I would say EC is the stronger going in. I think maybe their morale might be a bit better at the moment, you know, comparative to the IAM guys, but I'm on that one for IAM. I will say that.
Yeah, well, look, I mean, a lot of people are favouring IAM to go ahead and, you know, take on the Eternal Conflict team, but I think Eternal Conflict have been playing a while together. They got some really good players there, like Spoof and Link and Force. Lost Wolf as well, also adding quite a contribution. Defiant as well, one of the younger players that have really brought the newer talent, I guess, into the scene. So I wouldn't exactly write off the Eternal Conflict team, in my opinion. I mean, that's also going to be, you know, it's going to be hard to, it's going to be something like this, basically. But that is a best of three, and I know that's a best of three because that's how the league format works for the Do Gaming League. Otherwise,
surprisingly, we're more efficient for one thing than the Swedes. I mean, apparently we can organize gaming. Don't ask for roads without holes where cars disappear into, you know, but gaming, we got that.
I don't know if it's the Swedes that organize this. I don't actually know who, what team organizes this in, to be honest. What nationality, but I mean, I don't think it's a national thing, really. Look, so I did get confirmation out. It does seem like the Flipside Tactics team have won it. There's no third map as far as I can see between these two. I'm just waiting on... yep, there we go. GG, well played. Yeah, there we go. So the GGs have been called. Flipside Tactics are the winners there. 2-1 in that grand final. Guys, thank you very much for joining in. It was a little bit... A little bit awkward after the first map there. We didn't expect it to turn out like that. I mean, we kind of read the format in a particular way, and some of the other organizers and so forth. So hopefully next time it should be sorted. Anyway, guys, please click follow on the channel and like the Twitter and Facebook if you want for additional information on any international casts. Wookie, thank you very much for joining in on my cast this evening. It was fantastic having you around on the second map, and hopefully we'll chat again on Thursday night.
Right. Thanks, Bri. It was very nice as once again to cast with you, Mr. Red of the Burning Variety. Yeah, man. Very, 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 very nice CS to watch. I am so down to do that every time. I have adrenaline now. I'm not going to be able to sleep, I'm not going to lie. But, you know... Absolutely fantastic series to watch. Thank you very much.
Cool. No, thank you, man. Listen, I'll chat to you on Thursday. For the rest of you guys, have a fantastic evening.
May the 4th be with you.
Cool, man. Cheers. Don't tell me our youth is running out. It's only just begun. Don't tell me our youth is running out. It's only just begun. Don't bring me back. Yeah.